In this video, we will be discussing the multiple choice questions of Chapter 1, Social Science of Class 10, which is very important from board examination point of view as well as from competitive examination point of view. So let's start. The first question is, the Ottoman Turks captured the Constantinople on, the option A is 1463, 1553, 1498 and 1553. Guess what is the answer? Yes, it is option B, that is in the 1453 the Ottoman Turks captured the Constantinople. The next question is, gate of European trade, which is the gate of European trade? The first one is Mumbai, Kolkata, Constantinople and Rome. Guess what is the answer? Yes, it is Constantinople. The next question is, why Spain and Portugal started encouraging courageous sailors to find a sea route to India? So what is the reason for the Spain and Portugal for encouraging their sailors to find a sea route to India? This is the question. The option A is, all the trade routes connecting the city of Constantinople came under the control of Turks. That is the first reason. We have to choose whether it is correct or not. The next question is, the Turks started levying too many taxes on the goods passing through these routes, right? See, from the goods which were passing through the Constantinople, they are levying too many taxes on the Constantinople place. The next question, the next option is, the merchants felt that the trade was not profitable. And then the fourth option is all of the above. Then we have to choose which are these correct, right? See, all of the above are the correct reasons for the Spain and Portugal for encouraging their sailors to find a sea route to India, right? The next question is, who was the first to re-establish trade between India and Europe? After the Constantinople collapse, who were the first to re-establish the trade between the India and Europe? That is the question. The options are British, Turks, Portuguese and China. Yes, what is the answer? Yes, it is option C, that is Portuguese were the first to re-establish trade between India and Europe. The next question is, which Portuguese sailor in 1498 was successful in discovering a new sea route to India? See, which Portuguese sailor invented a new sea route to India is the question. The options are Vasco da Gama, Francisco de Almeida, and Alfonso de Albuquerque, and none of the above. What is the option? What is the right answer? Yes, yes, it is option A. Vasco da Gama was the right answer, who in 1498 was successful in discovering a new sea route to India. The next question is, Suez Canal was built in Egypt to connect the Red Sea and Mediterranean Sea, the Arabian Sea and Mediterranean Sea, the Bay of Bengal and Mediterranean Sea, and the Red Sea and Bay of Bengal. So what is the option you have to see? Let's see what is the option. Yes, it is option A. The Red Sea and Mediterranean Sea were connected by building a Suez Canal in Egypt. Option A is the right answer. The next question is, Vasco da Gama, Francisco de Almeida and Alfonso de Albuquerque were belonged to English, Portuguese, French and Dutch. Yes, what is the answer? They belong to Portuguese. All these persons were belong to Portuguese. The next question is, who implemented blue water policy? Which person implemented blue water policy? The first option is Vasco da Gama, Francisco de Almeida, Alfonso de Albuquerque, none of the above. What is the option? Guess. Yes, it is Francisco de Almeida who implemented the blue water policy. Francisco de Almeida implemented the blue water policy. The next question is, administrative center of Portuguese administration in India was Goa, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai. Yes, what is the answer? Yes, it is Goa, which was the administrative center of Portuguese in India. The next question is, which Portugal won a battle against the Sultan of Bijapur in 1510 and won Goa? Option A is Francisco de Almeida, Vasco da Gama, Alfonso de Albuquerque, Robert Clay. Yes, option C is the right answer. Alfonso de Albuquerque won a battle against Sultan of Bijapur in 1510 and won Goa. The next question is, what is blue water policy? What do you mean by blue water policy? It is establishing the supremacy over the sea instead of supremacy over the lands. Option B is establishing the supremacy over the lands instead of supremacy over the seas, and it is establishing the supremacy over the blue water, and option D is all of the above. Yes, what is the answer? Yes, it is option A. It is establishing the supremacy over the sea route instead of supremacy over the land. This is the blue water policy, which is implemented by the Portuguese. The next question is, Dutch are from, means Dutch are belonged to England, Africa, Australia and Holland or Netherlands. Which is the right answer? Yes, the Dutch are from Holland or Netherlands. The next question is, Queen Elizabeth issued a royal charter authorizing East India Company to trade with Eastern countries for 15 years in 1498 December 31, 1600 December 31, 1602 December 31, 1453 December 31. Guess what is the answer? Yes, it is option B. In 1600 December 31, Queen Elizabeth issued a royal charter authorizing East India Company to trade with Eastern countries for 15 years. The next question is, Dutch established United East India Company in 1602, 1498, 1869, 1453. Yes, option A is the right answer. In 1602, Dutch established United East India Company. The next question is, in 1617, which royal ambassador from the court of James I sought permission from Jahangir to establish factories in India? Right, options are Francisco de Almeida, Vasco da Gama, Alfonso de Albuquerque, and Sir Thomas Roe. Yes, what is the answer? Yes, so it is option D. Sir Thomas Roe was the royal ambassador from the court James I who sought permission from Jahangir to establish factories in India. The next question is, where did English built St. George Fort? This is a fort which was built by English in which place? That is the question. Option A is Madras, option B is Delhi, option C is Kolkata, option D is Surat. Guess what is the answer? Yes, it is option A, that is in Madras, English built St. George Fort. The next question is, where did English build Fort William Fort? S in Madras, Delhi, Kolkata, Surat. S in Kolkata, the English built Fort William Fort. Yes, CD. This is the St. George Fort, which was built by English in Madras, and Fort William Fort was built in Kolkata or Surat. The answer is Kolkata. The Fort William Fort was built in Kolkata, right? The next question is, the city of Calcutta lies on the banks of which river? It is on Hooghly River, on Ganga River, the Narmada River and Tapi River. Yes, it is option A, that is on Hooghly River, the city of Calcutta lies. The next question is, other name of Valikandapuram is Surat, Puducherry, Machilipatnam, Mahe. And option B is the right answer. That is option B, that is it. Puducherry is the other name of this place. The next question is, Carnatic Wars were fought between English and French, English and Portuguese, English and Dutch, and English and Bijapur Sultan, right? Karnataka Wars were fought between English and French. Yes, option A is the right answer. The next question is, how many Carnatic Wars were fought between English and French? Option A is 3, 4, 2, and 5. Yes, option A is the right answer. There were three Carnatic Wars were fought between English and French. The next question is, Hyderabad Kingdom was established in 1724 by Asaf Jah, Dost Ali, Anwaruddin, Chanda Sahib. Yes, what is the answer? It is option A. Asaf Jah was established Hyderabad Kingdom in 1724. The next question is, Dupleix was the Governor General of British, French, Portuguese, Dutch. It is option B, French. Dupleix was the French Governor General in India. The next question is, First Carnatic War ended with which treaty? Right? See, what is the treaty which was responsible for the First Carnatic War? This is the question. The question options are Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle, Treaty of Pondicherry, Treaty of Paris, and none of the above. What is the answer for this? Yes, that is option A is the right answer. Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle is the right answer, which was ended with First Carnatic War. The next question is, in Ambur battle, French, Chanda Sahib, and Muzaffar Jung defeated Nasir Jung, Asaf Jah and Nawab Anwaruddin and British. Option C is the right answer. That is, Nawab Anwaruddin was defeated by the French Chanda Sahib and Muzaffar Jung. Option C is the right answer. The next question is, the capital city of Karnatic was the Surat, Pondicherry, Machilipatnam, Arcot. S, what is the answer? S, it is option D, that is Arcot was the capital city of Karnatic. The next question is, the second Karnatic war ended with which treaty? Treaty of Pondicherry, Treaty of Aix-la-Chapel, Treaty of Paris, and none of the above. What is the answer? It is option A, that is Treaty of Pondicherry was the result of second Carnatic War. The next question is, Battle of Plassey took place in 1498, 1757, 1724, 1857. As it is option B is the right answer. In 1757, Battle of Plassey took place. The next question is, which of the following is are true? Robert Clive belonged to Second Carnatic War and Sir Arcot belonged to Third Carnatic War. Yes, option only one is correct. Option only B is only B. Two is correct. Option C is both one and two are correct. Neither one nor two are correct. Yes, guess what is the answer? Yes, option one and two are correct. Therefore, option C, both one and two is the correct. Robert Clive was the Governor General of India from the British during Second Carnatic War, and Sir Arcot was the head of the Third Carnatic War of the British in India. Right? Option, therefore, the option C, that is both one and two are the correct. The next question is, Third Carnatic War ended with Treaty of Pondicherry, Treaty of Aix-la-Chapel, Treaty of Paris, none of the above. Guess what is the answer? Yes, it is option C, that is Treaty of Paris. Therefore, the first Carnatic War ended with Treaty of Aix-la-Chapel, the second Carnatic War ended with Treaty of Pondicherry, and Third Carnatic War ended with Treaty of Paris. Please try to remember these three treaties which were very, very important from all examination point of view. The next question is, the Plassey battle took place between the Nawab Sirajuddin Dawla and British Ali Vardhan Khan and British Murshid Ali Khan and British the French and British. Yes, what is the answer? It is option A, that is Nawab Sirajuddin Dawla and British. The next question is, which are the two crucial wars which charted a decisive course to Indian history? It is Third and Second Carnatic War, First and Second Carnatic War, First and Third Carnatic War, Plassey and Buxar. Guess what is the answer? It is option D, that is Plassey and Buxar are the two crucial wars which charted a decisive course to Indian history. The next question is, Black Room tragedy was the main reason for the Second Carnatic War, First Carnatic War, Third Carnatic War, Plassey battle. S, it is option D, that is Plassey battle was the main reason for Black Room tragedy. The Black Room tragedy was the main reason for Plassey battle to happen. The next question is, who was the military head of Sirajuddaula? It is Nawab Sirajuddaula, Ali Vardhi Khan, Mir Jafar, Murshid Ali Khan. Right? S, it is Mir Jafar who was the military head of Sirajuddaula. The next question is, who won the Plassey battle? Whether it is British, whether it is French, whether it is Nawab Sirajuddaula, whether it is Murshid Ali Khan. S, it is option B. Right? Option B, that is French, won the Plassey battle. The next question is, what was the outcome of Plassey battle? Mir Jafar had to pay rupees 17 crore 70 lakhs as a relief fund to Sirajuddaula at the attack on the Fort William, or Mir Jafar became the Nawab of Bengal. So we have to choose whether these two are correct. Only one is correct, only two is correct. Both 1 and 2 are correct. Neither 1 and 2 are correct. Yes, what is the answer? Both 1 and 2 are the right answer. Means these are the two possible outcomes of the Plassey battle. That is, Mir Jafar had to pay rupees of this much amount to Sirajuddaula's attack on Fort William for British, and Mir Jafar became the Nawab of Bengal. These are the two outcomes of the Plassey battle. The next question is, who became the new Nawab after the British projected Mir Jafar as an inefficient Nawab? After Mir Jafar, who came into the power? That is the question. The Nawab Sirajuddaula, Ali Vardhi Khan, Mir Qasim, Murshid Ali Khan. Yes, what is the answer? It is option C. That is, Mir Qasim was the new Nawab after the British projected Mir Jafar as an inefficient Nawab. Therefore, option C is the right answer. The next question is, the battle that took place between the Shah Alam Shahzadullah Mir Qasim and British Army led by Hector Munro is First Carnatic War, Third Carnatic War, Buxar War, and it is Plassey Battle. Yes, it is the answer. That is C, Buxar War, that took place between Shah Alam II, Shujuddullah, and Mir Qasim and British Army. The next question is, which is very important, Battle of Buxar took place in 1764 1757 1761 1763. Yes, it is option A. That is, in 1764 Battle of Buxar took place, in 1757 Battle of Plassey took place. Therefore, the Battle of Buxar took place in 1764. Therefore, option A is the right answer. The next question is, which of the following is or are outcome of Battle of Buxar? Shah Alam II accorded the Diwani rights over the Bengal to British, and Shah Alam II gave away all the rights over the Bengal to British for an annual fees of 26 lakh. Option only one is correct, or only B, two is correct. Both one and two are correct. Neither one or two correct. Yes, option C is the right answer. Means both 1 and 2 are the outcomes of the Buxar battle. That is, Shah Alam accorded the Diwani rights over the Bengal to British, and he gave away all the rights over the Bengal to the British for an annual fee of rupees 26 lakh. These are the two dangerous outcomes of the Battle of Buxar in the Indian history. Therefore, the Plassey battle and the Buxar battle play a vital role in Indian history, which changed the entire scenario of Indian history. Therefore, they are very important. The next question is, Dastak, a license that can ensure anyone to import and export without paying any tax and transport goods anywhere, whether it is true or false. Means he is asking the definition for Dastak. It is a correct statement. Therefore, option A is the right answer. It is a true statement. Dastak is a license that can ensure anyone to import and export without paying any tax. The next question is, Diwani rights are nothing but. He is asking for the definition for Diwani rights. Again, he is giving the first statement, that is, a license that can ensure anyone to import and export without paying any tax and transport goods anywhere. Option B, the right to collect land taxes. Both 1 and 2 are correct. Option D, none of the above. Yes, guess what is the answer? It is B. Option B is the right answer. It is the right to collect land taxes. It is the option A is the definition for the Dastak, and option B is the definition for Diwani rights. Therefore, Diwani rights are nothing but the rights to collect the land taxes. The next question is, Robert Clive brought in dual government concept in 1765 1765 1757 1761. Yes, it is option A. In 1765, after the Battle of Buxar, Robert Clive brought in a dual government concept. That is, in 1765. The next question is, in a dual government, the British had the right to collect land taxes, whereas the Nawab had the power to administrative issues like justice and others. It is only one is correct, only two is correct. Both 1 and 2 are correct. Neither 1 nor 2. Yes, it is option B. C again, that is, both 1 and 2 are correct. In the dual government concept, the British had the right to collect land taxes, whereas the Nawab had the power over the administrative issues like justice and others. The next question is, which Mughal emperor issued a royal charter allowing the British to conduct their trade in Surat on the west coast and in Hooghly on the east coast? It is option B, that is, Jahangir allowed or issued a royal charter for them. That is, option B is the right answer. That is, Jahangir. The next question is, the English established their first warehouse in Madras, Surat, Calcutta, Delhi. Yes, it is option A, that is, in Madras, English established their first warehouse. The next question is, French East India Company was established in France, London, Surat, Madras. Yes, it is in France. Option A is the right answer. The next question is, the capital of French in India was Surat, Madras, Puducherry, Bombay. Option C is the right answer. That is, Puducherry or Pondicherry is the capital of French in India. The next question is, the Diwani rights over Bengal were handed over the British by. It is Shah Alam. The next question is, the dual government policy was implemented by which Governor General in Bengal? It is Robert Clive. The next question is, in 1757, Robert Clive declared a dash war over the, which war over the Sirajuddola? It is option B. Obviously, in 1757, Robert Clive declared Plassey Battle or Plassey War over the Sirajuddola. The next question is, Treaty of Paris occurred in 1763. It is in 1763, Treaty of Paris occurred. Right, these are the most important questions we had discussed in this chapter. So thank you one and all. So if you like this video, please subscribe, share and like. So thank you one and all once again.